Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Jason Merrill, and I'm the creative director here at WebTegrity. So no, I'm not Corey, and that may disturb some of you guys, but she has asked her team members to make videos to get a little bit more advanced with WordPress and kind of what is possible within your WordPress website. So today what I want to do for you guys is show you how to animate something on your website, just a quick hover over effect. And I want to do this because a lot of people get intimidated when it comes to different animation effects. They feel like they need to get involved with JavaScript or something like that. And it's simply not that complex. So here I have a Catholic school here in San Antonio. I want to use them as an example. And I want to show you guys just how easy it is to animate something with a hover over effect. So here we have, if I hover over the logo here, just a quick little effect. Of course, it links back to the homepage, but it's just something that adds just a little bit of engagement, and it's little things like this that can make a website fun. But if I scroll down, some feedback that they gave me is that if they hover over the Instagram feed, it has no animation effect. Like, there's no way to know that it clicks off besides the little cursor hand. So they wanted just a quick way to add a little bit of engagement to this, and I said, no problem. We're going to do this with literally two lines of CSS. So I'm going to inspect it here inside of Chrome, and I'm going to work inside of the inspector style sheet here. Now, if you know anything about style sheets, you'll know any change that I make here, I'll need to add to my style sheet on the back end. So please keep that in mind. This is a great area to play, but eventually you're going to need to copy it and put it in your actual style sheet if you want the changes to be permanent. But when it comes to any kind of reoccurring element, like a picture area is a good scenario for a reoccurring element, I like to use unordered lists because it adds structure that's easy to predict and use within a style sheet. But if you set up, like, maybe you're trying to do this on some type of gallery and you use divs instead of list items, it can work the same way. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this list item. This is the parent list item that's being used for this image inside of here. And you'll see I already have some CSS for that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab that, and I want to add a hover effect to this. So I'm just going to create a new CSS line inside of this inspector element. And I'm just going to add the pseudo class of hover to the list item. So this is to say, when I hover over this list item, I want you to activate whatever CSS properties I put within here. And I'm going to put a transform property, and I'm going to use the scale function. Now, there's a lot of different things you can do with transform, but I like scale in this case because I just want it to pop out a little bit. You can do a lot with transform. You can have it move from side to side. You can have it jump up. There's a lot of different things that you can do with it. So I'm going to put the scale at 1.5 just to show you that you can really make these things explode out. But I think in this case, that's a little bit too large. So I'm going to go with like a 1.1. And there we go. Real subtle. But it still doesn't feel like an animation, does it? You hover over it and it pops out at you, and that's great. But in order to get that transition that animations have, we need to go to the parent class here, and we just need to add one property. Now, we don't want to add this property onto the hover effect, because then it will only be active when you hover over it, and you want it to ease in and out. So we're going to add it on this area right here, and we're going to use the property transition, and we use this all the time. This is like the standard for me. I type all ease 0.3 seconds to say I want this transition to happen when it hovers on and off. So I want it to go both ways. There's different types of transition effects. I'm using ease because I think it's one of the best. And then I can tell it the period of time in which it does its transition. And 0.3 seconds, seconds is like the standard. It's very subtle, not too quick, not too slow. And now we have this nice effect here to where it feels like an animation, and it feels like a lot more engaging than it was previously. And we did that with literally two lines of CSS. It's very simple, nothing to be intimidated about, and you can add this effect all over the site. It doesn't just work with transform. This is also the transition property is what you should be putting on anything that you have changing colors when you hover over it. So you'll notice this has that nice transition. It's not a sharp jump when you hover over it. So it's little things like that really add a lot of spunk to a site. And I hope this video has helped you guys out. Of course, remember, you're not done. You want to copy this, put this in your style sheet, or since this is already in my style sheet, I would just grab that last line and make sure that is over there as well. So if you guys have any questions with WordPress, for some of you who've been watching Corey for a while and you want to get more advanced, please let me know in the comments section. I'm happy to hit them up, either me or one of the other team members. We have a lot of very talented developers here that I'm sure would love to get as nerdy as you'd like to get with WordPress. But that's all I have for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.